Thank you for your interest in Medicare cost reporting. You have accessed part one in a four-part webinar series discussing Medicare cost reporting for critical access hospitals. These webinars are designed for individuals who may not be familiar with the Medicare cost report and are hoping to learn more about it. For additional information, please access parts two through four of the cost reporting webinar series, as well as other focused educational webinars sponsored by the Wisconsin Office of Rural Health. Part one will introduce the Medicare cost report and discuss the worksheet S series. So the Medicare cost report is basically a financial document that is due within 5 months after your fiscal year end. It is something that is filed with Medicare and can also be used by a number of other different users, which we'll look at in a couple of slides here. But overall, it basically determines what Medicare owes your hospital, what Medicare share of the cost of hospital operations is. There are standard forms that Medicare provides and that we have, most of your cost report preparers will have software for that they use to enter in information. And basically what we're reporting is your historical data so Medicare can determine what they owe you. Medicare is obviously the main user of the cost report. They use this to determine the cost settlement at the end of the year, whether the hospital facility is owed money from Medicare or they potentially owe Medicare money, depending on how the end of the year settlement comes out. The cost report is also used to determine your interim rates and can be used to file rate adjustments throughout the year if you're going to be filing interim cost reports, but definitely at the end of the year, your rate will get updated based on the results of that cost report. Different state Medicaid programs also use the Medicare cost report for potentially cost settlement, annual rate setting, and determining other things like hospital assessments or state hospital taxes. It really depends on the state Medicaid program, but those are definitely some options that the states have or that they use the cost report for. The other user would be private insurance companies. They're not going to be cost settling, but they do use the cost report to determine reasonableness of percentage of charges for contract negotiations, and the Medicare fee schedule is also a popular metric used by insurance companies to set different rates for hospitals. Other users would obviously be all the different hospital facilities that are filling out the cost reports. The cost report is a very helpful tool for determining the reasonableness of monthly contractual adjustments, contractual allowance calculations. It's a very good tool to use for a high level service line analysis to look at different costs. The cost to charge ratio is a big metric that we can use to see just at a very high level how we're performing at a department level. Can be used in the budgeting process, rate or price setting, and contract negotiations, like we mentioned in that previous slide. Other organizations do utilize this Medicare cost report data to include in benchmarking reports, benchmarking analysis. Congress looks at the Medicare cost report data as a whole. And so do many other state and regional healthcare groups, organizations, cooperatives will use this data to compile together to hopefully help out especially all of our rural facilities with that benchmarking and financial data. So the cost report is laid out in a sequential, well, almost sequential, series of worksheets. And you can see here on this graphic on the screen, all of them have a letter that corresponds to the different series of worksheets. And each of those different series of worksheets have a specific section of the cost report data that is reported in that worksheet series. So in this first video that we're going through today, just kind of giving you this high level overview, and we'll go through worksheet S. The next series of videos will go through worksheet A and B, which is more of the expense side of things. Worksheet C and D and E will be separated out later as well on, I believe, video number 4, and that is where we are going to be reporting most of the revenue information. It's just kind of a high-level breakdown of what all the different cost report worksheets look like and what just a basic description of what information is reported on those worksheets. The cost report flow, again, this is just kind of looking at that previous slide in a different way. Worksheet A is really worried about the expenses. It breaks down further into worksheet A, A6, A8, A1, A2, and A3. And we'll go through all those worksheets in a little bit more detail in video number two. Worksheet B, again, deals with expenses, but more so on the overhead allocation. So all of the overhead cost centers that are present in a Medicare cost report. We use worksheet B1 to report all of our different stats that we use to allocate all those overhead cost centers down into our revenue producing cost centers. So that's what worksheet B is used for. Worksheet C is where we're reporting all of our gross charges. We do include a few reclasses and adjustments to back up things like professional fees out of worksheet C, but basically is where we're reporting all of our gross charges. Worksheet D is where we are reporting our Medicare or potentially Medicaid charges for the states that use the cost report to help set rates. We will report separate Medicaid charges on worksheet D as well. But for the most part, this is where all the different Medicare charges from the PSNR, which we'll talk about later as well, summarizing all that information that we get from Medicare and recording it on the related line here. Worksheet E is a summary of what Medicare has paid us during the year, and this will report our overall settlement. So we'll compare what Medicare has paid us compared to what Medicare should have paid us, and that will come up with our settlement. So that takes care of our high-level introduction, high-level look at all the different components of the cost report. And like I mentioned, we're going to go into each one of these different worksheet series in a little bit more detail now. So we'll start with worksheet S right away here in this first video session. Worksheet S is the first worksheet in the series of worksheets on the Medicare cost report. And this is really more informational. This is where Medicare is collecting a lot of information from the hospital. And this honestly is a form that is really, we always say that this is one of the most important forms in the entire cost report, even though all you're really doing is entering information, a lot of yes, no questions, very similar to a 990, which I know a lot of our critical access hospitals are used to filing. Those yes, no answers really trigger more schedules or more in-depth information needed later in the cost report. The same thing happens in the cost report. We are answering questions to hopefully aid in our preparation of the cost report and also hopefully increase reimbursement. And we'll go through a couple different opportunities here. You know, some answers that we want to look at a little bit closer to make sure that we're optimizing reimbursement. So at a high level, the worksheet S is where we are seeing on the first page of the cost report, we're seeing what our estimated settlement is. And that's basically broken down into Part A, Part B, and then if you have rural health clinics, that'll be reported here. Skilled nursing facilities will be reported here. So we'll see that breakdown between all those different types of Medicare patients or different types of Medicare payments, and we'll see that overall settlement at the bottom of the page. And this is also what your cost report preparer will send to you to sign at the end of the year, attesting that the cost report is basically prepared to the best of your ability. You know of no fraudulent items that were disclosed, and this is something that the cost report preparer will work with the hospital facility to get signed. So we'll start, we'll jump in. There's a couple of basic parts of worksheet S. S2 is the first part, and this is really the informational part. And this is where all of these questions that I was talking about are coming across, and it's very important to read each one of these questions. A lot of them get into a little bit of detail, and some that can be a little bit confusing. Instructions are definitely available if needed, and go into a little bit better description of what the question is actually asked. But each of these questions does become very important because it triggers various cost report worksheets that will be needed to that we need to include or not include depending on the answer to each one of these questions. To start with, this is also where we're inputting a lot of our information: our address, our hospital component identifiers. What type of hospital it is, whether it's a CAH or PPS facility, and other things related to rural health clinics, dates of attestation, dates that become a little bit pretty important when we're talking about filing this cost report at the end of the year. If those dates aren't correct, there's potential for these cost reports for Medicare to not accept the cost report. So we want to make sure that we're paying attention to all the dates and addresses, and making sure that they're as accurate as possible. Worksheet S3 Part 1. So S2 is where we're basically giving all the information. S3 Part 1 is informational, but this is the first part of the cost report that we're actually reporting financial information that is directly going to impact the settlement. S2, none of that information is going to be financial in nature. That's again more yes, no questions. So S3 part one is the first worksheet that we're going to be importing actual financial data. A lot of people will, they don't quite understand exactly how important S3 part one is. S3 part one is where we're basically reporting all of our census information, all of our days information, number of beds at the end of the cost reporting period, our critical access hours, days, discharges, FTEs. There's a lot of information reporting here, but we'll go through, the most important pieces of data. So number of beds, like I mentioned, that is one item that's reported here. Your critical access hours is another item that's reported on S3 Part 1. And this becomes important because we want to make sure that we can demonstrate that we are in compliance with the 96-hour rule. So that is important to not overlook your critical access hospital hours and that to make sure that they're calculated correctly. And you can see on that bullet point, we want to make sure that we are excluding swing bed, nursing home, and observation hours in that calculation. The other item that we're reporting in S3 Part 1 is your total patient days. So we split that out between Medicare, Medicaid, Medicare Advantage, Medicaid Managed Care, and total days. We want to make sure that these are as accurate as possible, as we'll look in further slides, as this can really directly affect the settlement at the end of the year. And to optimize reimbursement, one of the easiest ways to try to find areas that we potentially are overlooking or different areas of opportunity, the cost report days that we're reporting are one of the most important things. You can see as this chart shows, basic assumptions when we're talking about our reimbursement is the higher the patient days are, or the larger the increase is from a previous cost reporting period, your routine cost per day is decreased. And your basic assumption there is the denominator in the equation, if that's increasing, your routine cost per day is decreasing. Kind of on the flip side of things, if your patient days are decreasing, your routine cost per day, your reimbursement is actually going to be increasing. There's different analysis that you can do to figure out kind of what that break-even payer mix is, but those are just at a very high level. You can know if between years you can look at your cost report, and if your patient days are up from the previous period, you can assume that you're most likely looking at a decrease in reimbursement and a potential payback on your cost report at the end of the year. Well, that is all that we have for Worksheet S. Appreciate everybody taking the time to listen and hope that you will join us for videos 2, 3, and 4. I'll be with you in video 2, and we will go over the Worksheet A series of cost report work papers.